Tesla CEO Elon Musk recently announced that the company expects to offer a full self-driving product to the public in 2021. Autonomous vehicle technology is already being tested and trained on public roads in live traffic. Autonomous vehicles could make our roads safer. Could they also provide an opportunity to reimagine the role of cars in our lives and prioritize humans in urban design? Autonomous vehicles, or AVs, will provide noteworthy, immediate expected benefits. According to the AAA in 2019, Americans spent 70 billion hours driving. Another study found that the average American spends 18 days per year behind the wheel. That's over 2 weeks, longer than the average vacation. AVs could free up all that time for work, leisure, or rest. AVs will also save lives by eliminating crashes due to driver error, the primary cause of 94% of all accidents. We won't see the full benefit of this, though, as long as human drivers remain on the road. Combined with three other technologies, electric vehicles, mobility as a service, and the Internet of Things, AVs will have other benefits as well. Fully autonomous electric vehicles are the way of the future, not hybrids as originally thought. Unlike hybrids, electric vehicles produce no tailpipe emissions. This would reduce pollution, cutting into the nearly 8 million years of lost life attributed to deaths from tailpipe emissions in 2015. As much as half of the land area in a modern American city is dedicated to parking lots, street parking, service stations, and other car-related infrastructure. With mobility as a service, companies like Uber could provide AVs on demand right to your location, eliminating the need for much of this infrastructure. That's a big deal when you consider the average driver in the United States spends 17 hours a year just looking for parking. In big cities, this number is over 100 hours per year. With EVs, everyone can have VIP service with their own robotic chauffeur to drop them off right at their destination. This means that parking areas, charging facilities, and cleaning and maintenance stations could be located outside of city centers, resulting in more room for pedestrians, green spaces, leisure, and business. Multiple studies have found that urban green spaces can reduce stress while improving mental and physical health. The rise of convenient, shared AVs would also mean that garages, driveways, and street parking in residential areas could be repurposed or eliminated altogether. Beyond that, it could free people from having to register, insure, inspect, and maintain a personal vehicle. But people need to be excited about autonomous vehicles and willing to forgo the independence provided by vehicle ownership. The benefits, efficiencies, and safety of AVs will have to be clear. Today's AVs find out about roads, lane markers, and traffic signs through a combination of GPS and onboard sensors. Yet other vehicles and current conditions are only taken into account when they encounter them through the sensors. However, they can't react to what they don't see. Vehicle-to-everything communication, or V2X, could solve that problem. Using V2X, AVs could communicate and share information directly with roads, other vehicles, devices, and more. Beyond eliminating much of the need for traffic signals and road signs, V2X would enable AVs to share information about routes, planned movements, and hazards. AVs could also navigate intersections without stopping, always giving priority to emergency vehicles and avoiding unexpected detours and other problems. While this future is promising, there's still much work to be done. Most AVs operate at level 2 automation, meaning that the vehicle can operate itself, but a human driver is required to monitor the vehicle and take control if needed. To reach the goals described here, AVs would have to approach level 5, or full autonomy. There are technical challenges to this, and data from everyday drivers is already being collected to train AVs. It's also going to require public will. Laws and regulations will need to be changed to allow these AVs to operate. These changes won't occur immediately, but with enough engaged people, this can be done. And with honking cars, angry drivers, and the din of internal combustion engines a thing of the past, perhaps our idea of a city soundscape will have to change as well. The rise of AVs combined with these other technologies will provide regional planners the opportunity to reimagine our environment and design it for people rather than for cars. Follow the links below to see how you can help. Like, follow, subscribe, and catch us next time to see how you, plus science, can help save the world.